We will see it in the part of restoration.
After you have cried that, Lord, have mercy on me, according to unmerited favor, have mercy on me, against you have I sinned, deliver me. There is a path of deliverance. When a Christian sins, the devil curses. When a Christian sins, the devil deposits sin within his human body. Therefore, after God has forgiven you according to his unmerited favor, you need deliverance. For sin is living within you. If it leaves the sin alive within you, it will keep on reminding you of that which you have done, and it's going to kill you with guilt. So after you cry that, Lord, according to your unmerited favor, forgive me, you need to cry for deliverance. Says, listen to what David is saying. David said, Lord, wash away my nakedness. Wash away, pull away all my transgressions. For I know my sins and my transgressions are right against me. Therefore, after you pray for the mercy of God, for forgiveness, there is a need to pray for the Lord to deliver you. I know it's a hard prayer, but it's a sacrifice to make for the effectiveness of our Christianity. I know it's not a nice thing, it's a deeper thing, but it's a prayer that you have to stand boldly and say, I refuse to not make this prayer. Lord, against you have I sinned. Lord, have mercy on me. The devil is a liar. I know the devil hates to see Christians pray, making this kind of a prayer. You need to boldly, you need to sacrifice. You need to bow down and say, Lord, have mercy on me. Wash away all my iniquities. When you pray, what are you doing? You are releasing yourself. You are releasing the giant within. No way the devil can love this. The devil has to keep back. When you cry for forgiveness, when you cry for God to forgive, when you cry for God to wash away. Because if you can be clean and get yourself together, you will destroy the enemy. These are the one kinds of the prayers that they are sacrificial prayers. As Brother Elijah has spoken about a sacrifice. These are the prayers that even though it's hard, I kneel down and I cry. Amen. And the second step is restoration. After I have sinned and God came in his mercy and forgive me, and God washed away all my nakedness, when the enemy attracts and crushes down, the spirit lives. That's why David said, Lord, don't take your spirit from me. The joy is nice, it's wonderful, it's great to dwell in the presence of the Lord and move in his joy, praise and worship him, receive the gifts of the Lord, but all of a sudden you fall. It brings a grievance to your soul. It moves you from your position of joy. That's why David came and said, Lord, restore unto me the joy of salvation. Restore unto me the steadfast spirit. I want to find that boldness. I want to get the strength. And he gave himself together in the position with the Lord and in the position of his power. So, Church of the Most High, all these things happen within the human body. All these things happen within the human body. But I'm here to say unto you, Lord, I'm here to say unto you, Church of the Most High, that the high priest died for you. No matter how tough they are, the high priest died for you. The high priest of good news died for you. He sacrificed not the blood of the lamb and the goats that couldn't wash away your sins. But the blood of the lamb and the goats were the blood of the creation. The creation couldn't redeem the creation, but it took the blood of God to redeem the creation. So I'm here to say unto you, when you declare the blood, just know that I'm bringing myself together. I'm stepping into the Holy of Holies. For the Bible said the high priest entered into a tabernacle that is not man-made, that is not part of the creation. So when you move with the priest, you are stepping into the Holy of Holies. You are stepping into the tabernacle that is not man-made, that is supernatural. So you are no more led by the instructions of men, but you are led by the Spirit. You are led by the supernatural kingdom. You are led by the kingdom of the Lord. So the Holy of Holies is your home. This is what I have for the church. The church of the Most High. Let's come all the way back and acknowledge that Christ died for us. You will experience the power. It's not that you are totally faithful. You will experience the anointing because the high priest died for you. If it wasn't by the high priest, you should have been struggling to feel the power. You should have been struggling to feel the anointing. Want to say Jesus. Want to say Jesus. Know and understand that I'm crushing everything. I'm delivering my body. I'm cleaning my body so that I can get myself together and pray unto the Lord. And it shall be as I pray. So we need to acknowledge the blood of the Lamb, the blood of the high priest. Lord, I thank you. That's the end of the message. Let's have a song of praise. Let's have a give God thanks. Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Jesus.